Yo, what's up guys, John Boogle here. Now, what should you do after Chapter 3 Moon? Some of you may have seen this video, of course, the beginner progression guide. And in that video, we explored everything about, well, almost everything about the beginner phase of the game and what to do after Empire of Cats Chapter 3. Well, in this video, I'm gonna take that a bit further. I'm gonna break it apart, and this time we're gonna solely focus on what to do right after Empire of Cats 3. And not go too far ahead in the beginner phase. So in the beginner's progression guide, I mentioned how you should go into SOL unless you have the good anti-alien units and such. And the reason that is because going through SOL, you're gonna build up XP a lot faster, you're gonna build up cat food a lot faster, you're gonna get base materials to upgrade your cat cannons, of course you'll be able to grind cat fruits, XP, cat tickets, just a lot more stuff you can get from just progressing in SOL compared to Into the Future. And that's pretty much all explained in the other guide, but I didn't dive into many of the details, the smaller details of the beginner phase. Stuff like user rank. User rank is actually mega important in the beginner phase because you unlock caps for your levels at these user rank rewards. And of course, as you can see, at 1200 user rank, rare cast can get upgraded to level 30, which is a huge benchmark, because that is when you unlock true form units, being able to upgrade your rare cast to level 30, evolving them to true forms, which is very crucial. And of course at 1300 user rank, you get the super rare cap up to level 30, and you'll be able to get those true forms as well. Also, in that summarized version of the progression guide, I wasn't able to dive into the details of what units you want to focus on and what units you would want to upgrade. But before that, of course, one thing. One very important thing about the beginner phase, and this applies to the end game phase as well, because it's very similar. Not only for your normal levels, but also for grinding rare cat tickets. So, yes. Of course, if you couldn't tell already, I'm talking about farming cat tickets. Cat tickets is a very big part that people tend to ignore. What you have to realize here is you're not only farming cat tickets to get your normal levels up, but eventually when you have all of your cat base upgrades at plus 10, that is all the blue power-ups, of course, like cat research, cat efficiency, cat cannon attack power, recharge, stuff like that. Once you get them maxed, when you pull those upgrades in the cat ticket capsules, of course, you can trade that towards one rare ticket or a portion towards a rare ticket. So when you trade a total of 5 of those duplicate blue power-ups, the base upgrades, you can get one rare ticket, which is huge. A very huge thing. Like, people always ask, Boogle, how do you get so many of these gacha units so early in the game? How do you get so many Ubers in such a short time? Well, the answer is grinding cat tickets, because cat tickets is the key not only for the beginner phase. Of course, having your normal's true form in the beginning of the game is a huge help, but also working towards building up your rare tickets and unlocking new gacha units to build your roster of units, expanding your ability to make more lineups and get more cat combos, and of course, have more ways to counter levels, because sometimes you might reach a level where you're missing the right units, and that's always a big letdown for a lot of people, and grinding rare tickets can get you out of that situation. Of course, it is down to RNG at the end of the day, but there isn't many people in the game who reached too far without missing out on all of the key gacha units. Of course, at a certain point in the game, you're gonna have access to all of the key gacha units, unless you're super, super unlucky, or unless you've been spending your cat food wrong, or not grinding cat tickets. Now back to user rank, you must be wondering, Boogle, with such scarce amount of XP in the beginner phase, how am I supposed to get user rank? Well, as I was scrolling by my units previously, of course, little cats. If you have access to a stage that drops lucky tickets, do it, because not only do you get a whole bunch of power-ups from lucky tickets, but you also get the little cats, which is a very great source to get user rank. Easy to get, very, very cheap to upgrade, and you'll also build up a lot of battle items or power-ups while grinding lucky cat tickets. So of course, The thing you should really focus on is, of course, SOL stages, but cat tickets. Grinding cat tickets, not only the regular cat tickets or silver cat tickets, but when you have the chance to get lucky cat tickets, not the lucky cat ticket G, because those do not drop the little cats, but the regular lucky tickets, they drop little cats as well as the battle items slash power-ups. So I do recommend getting those as they could help you build up your user rank very quickly in the beginner phase. And when of course you do reach that benchmark user rank and you unlock the ability to get your units, your rare cats to level 30, you will be met with a decision on what units to true form. And it really depends on what units you have, but the ones you want to go for is the key gacha units. Now let's say you're really struggling on a stage and if you true form an example unit, you'll beat the stage. Yes, you can do that, but you won't get that much benefit from it in the future unless it's like one of the key gacha units. So of course, main thing in the beginning is not to go for your crowd control units, because some of them are good enough at level 10. Even at level 1, stuff like Necro and Gunslinger, like these are units in the beginner phase where you could keep at level 1 and they could do their job at the same level. But then it gets tricky because then you get crowd control units like Sanzo or Bishop Cat. Now Sanzo is one of the key gacha units and I highly recommend true forming Sanzo if you do have Sanzo. And one of the first choices I would go for is either Artist Cat or Ramen Cat, Commando Cat slash Cameraman Cat, and Sanzo. And the reason Sanzo is in there as a crowd control unit because Sanzo is just such a powerful unit to have in the beginning of the game, going against a lot of Bun Buns and going against all the Cyclones. It just completely obliterates all of those stages and completely controls the fight. That is why Sanzo is up there with units like Cameraman and Ramen. Now, Cameraman and Ramen are another two of the key gacha units, though honestly, it is a choice between Cameraman and Cyborg. I would argue that Cyborg is actually better for the beginner phase because not only does it have more range, but the extra health is very helpful because Cyborg can like 1v1 some Master A's in SOL. And that is a huge thing to have. Being able to solo Master A with a Cyborg spam in those early SOL subchapters is very, very helpful. That is something Cameraman cannot do, but as you go on, of course, Cameraman does become a lot more valuable, so it's not like you should ignore Cameraman, but for the key gachas, of course, I would do Cameraman first, then Cyborg after, because Paris Cat, a level 30 Paris Cat, can still tear through Master A's by just spamming Paris, so yeah. Now if you chose the path of Into the Future, of course the cats I would recommend is Catalyte or Rover Cat. Chill Cat is a very solid unit to have. Of course the DPS is pretty high on Chill Cat, but other than that, really the standout rare key gacha units is just Cameraman, Sanzo, Cyborg, and I guess you could throw in Thaumaturge in there as well and Elemental Duelist, but they're not as important as the ones mentioned previously. Now the even bigger benchmark is the Super Rare Cats, because at level 30 Super Rare Cats you have access to some of the most powerful units in the game, not only for the beginner phase but all the way up to end game as well. Now, as for the key decision or the key gacha units I would go for here, there is a lot. There's definitely a lot in the super rare category, but the absolute two main ones to go for is Can-Can or Cyberpunk. So Dancing Flasher or Hacker Cat, getting both of those to true form is a huge, huge power leap. And following that, stuff like Sadako or Octocat, Fishman, and of course Pizza Cat, which is very, very crucial for grinding the XP stages. And of course on the lower end of the key gacha spectrum, you have of course Apple Cat or iCat, Seafarer Cat, and Roe Cat. But sometimes it's better to go for these specific options. Like I mentioned previously, Let's say you have Hacker Cat and you can true form Hacker Cat, but you also want to beat Crazed Axe and you haven't beat it yet, but you have Apple Cat and you could also true form Apple Cat to iCat and completely just wipe Crazed Axe off the field. So what do you go with here? Now, if you really want to beat Crazed Axe, of course, the right decision here is just to get iCat. But the better decision is, of course, to just go with Cyberpunk, because Cyberpunk is just way more valuable and will help for a tremendous more amount of stages. So when you are in a situation when you have to true form one or the other, think about the future as well and not only right now, because keep in mind, in the beginner phase, you're not going to have that much cat fruits because you're going to be trying to get as much as possible, trying to get all of your units awakened into their true forms, and that goes up all the way into the mid game where you get even more of your units true formed for those specific situations, stuff like, of course, Housewife Cat for those zombie stages and stuff like that. So cat tickets, cat fruits, choosing the right key gacha units, all a very big part. And another big thing in the beginner phase, which I should have mentioned earlier, is Crazed Whale. Crazed Whale is a cheat code, is a very nice cheat code to have in the beginner phase, and it requires only level 25 cats to get. This is literally all you have to do to get Crazed Whale. Yes, you might need Paris Cat. I mean, you can try a level 30 Mother Cat, but I don't think that will work out too great unless you have a level 30 Bahamut. But if you have a level 20 Bahamut, level 25 Paris Cat, and at least 3 Stallers, then you could pretty much beat Crazed Fish with Space Cat. Yes, Space Cat. The cat that drops from the cyclone, in specific, the red cyclone. Beating the red cyclone has a chance to drop, of course, Space Cat. And getting Space Cat to level 25 for, of course, the Crazed Fish stage is one of the very easy ways to obtain such a powerful unit in such an early point of the game. Now, I mentioned this previously in the video I did before, in my using my own guide video, that Crazed Whale can actually solo into the future with all the treasures. So Crazed Whale is a big asset for the beginner phase, letting you tank all of those pesky units like Master A and a lot of the Nyandoms, and being able to just tear down a lot of units, being able to tank and stall the enemies. Crazed Whale is just a powerhouse of a unit in the beginner phase, has a lot of health, has great damage, great DPS at such a low cost, and a decent recharge rate. It is just a cheat code to have for the beginner phase. So yeah, going for the Cyclones in the beginner phase right after Empire of Cats Chapter 3 is a good decision, because specifically the Red Cyclone going for Space Cat allows you to get that critter you need for Crazed Fish. Because of course, Crazed Fish has a Super Metal Hippo, which you of course need a critter unit to counter it. Now there is some situations where you might be able to get even more Crazed Cats depending on what units you have. Like, I have Swimmer and Sadako, as you can see in this lineup, and I used both of these key gacha units to tear down Crazed Bird, and I was able to get Crazed Bird with level 25 cats. Using just level 20 Crazed Whale, 25 or level 26 Swimmer, and of course 25 Sadako, and Crazed Bahamut, Paris level 25 of course, and Bahamut level 20, and I think we also used Pirate Cat just for some crowd control for the Red Boar, and not even level 10. Level 1 Pirate Cat. It just goes to show that having your crowd control units at level 30 is not needed at all, unless you're going for the true form like Sanzo, but wasting your XP to getting your crowd control units to level 30 is unnecessary, because they work just fine at level 1, really, for the beginner phase. Speaking of wasting XP, of course XP management is a big thing in the beginner phase. Being able to balance your XP spending and being able to stably grind XP as well. Helping you progress in user rank and getting true forms is very crucial, so spending XP on not so great crowd control units is not a great investment. So don't stress if your witch cat is level 1, if your pirate cat is level 1, they are fine. The units you want to get to level 30 is your key gacha units and of course your main attackers. Now ubers. When it comes to ubers, it's very difficult, but I would actually say to avoid upgrading ubers at all in the beginner phase, unless it's something like completely broken, if you have one of the fest ubers, or maybe an anti-black uber that could really help you out in the XP stages. Otherwise, I would really recommend avoiding upgrading your ubers for a little bit, because that'll save you so much XP where you can distribute to all of your key gacha units and get them true formed. You have to invest in these key gacha units and build up a better foundation for all of your lineups. Upgrading only your ubers will lead to your team falling apart, not to having a good foundation with those key gacha units, so keep that in mind. Another big thing is, of course, XP spreading. And if you don't know what XP spreading is, it's when a player decides to upgrade a unit but then halfway stops and goes to upgrade another unit. And when they do that, they of course spread their XP across two different units without maxing either one of them. And that is a very big setback, because of course, focusing on one unit at a time allows you to bring out the max potential in the unit and get the most value. So avoid upgrading several units at once. Focus on one unit at a time, finish one unit, and move on to the next. And of course, the choice of what unit to upgrade is also a big thing. So yes, the key gacha units is of course the solid decision. After that, yes, you can work on your pirate cat or witch cat or whatever uber you would like to upgrade. That is just the most efficient way where you'll progress a lot more quicker and you'll have a solid foundation for all of your lineups. Now, the last thing I want to talk about here is cat food. After Empire of Cats Chapter 3, I would highly recommend to just start saving all of your cat food. And of course, there is the obvious things like don't spend your cat food on continues, don't spend your cat food on single rolls, and do not spend your cat food on Uberfest. Do not do it. Yes, you might get some extra super rares here and there, but you're way better off spending your cat food on guaranteed Uber rolls. And you're wondering, Boogle, so you're telling me to just skip Uberfest and Epicfest? Well, no, because that is why you grind cat tickets to, of course, obtain rare cat tickets and spend all of those on Uberfest, Epicfest, and whichever banner that is in that similar realm. Now, buying the special cats, I would recommend buying the cheaper ones to not only get some user rank, but for those cat combos as well. But I would avoid buying the more expensive special cats until there's a discount. Yes, there is discounts on these special cats sometimes, and when that discount arrives, you'll be able to pick up all the special cats at half price, which is the best possible time, and the only time you should really buy those more expensive special cats for those cat combos slash true forms in the future. But really, the best cat food tip at the beginning of the game is, of course, just progress through SOL and save your cat food for guaranteed uber rare draws, because that is where you'll get the most value, and of course, you'll walk away with a guaranteed uber, whether it be a useful uber or not, because you always want to use your new units you get, because of course, it'll help with cat combos and of course, stuff in the future as well. Now, NP is more a topic for the end of the beginner phase and the beginning of the mid-game phase, so I won't cover that in this video here, but keep in mind that there is a goal for dupes in the future, so maybe if you're close to finishing Into the Future Chapter 3, hanging on to the few extra dupes of like your crowd control units like Pirate Cat and stuff like that would be pretty helpful for getting a bunch of NP. But yeah, that's pretty much it for everything right after Empire of Cast 3 I would do or focus on. Of course, another thing I could throw in here is if you see two capsules right here, of course, for the normal cat tickets, you get the ones with the cat fruit and the battle items slash power-ups, or you have a choice for the regular cat tickets. In this situation, I would actually choose the regular cat tickets over the one that include cat fruits and power-ups, because you have a much higher chance, of course, pulling the normal cats for getting your true forms and getting those plus levels, but also you have a higher chance of getting those base upgrades which you can trade for rare cat tickets or a portion towards rare cat tickets, which is very, very important. So go for the regular cat capsules, don't get the ones with the cat fruits and power items. You have a way less chance of not only getting more rare cat tickets, but getting more plus levels. So yeah, the normals are the way to go. But yeah, drop a like if this helped you out, subscribe if you're new, join the hashtag Boogle Gang. Maybe I'll go into even more detail going through the beginner phase and break apart even more parts of the beginner phase and go into more detail and parts of the progression guide I mentioned in the beginning of the video. So keep an eye out in the future to see more videos like this going into even more detail about the progression of the game. But yeah, it's been John Boogle and see ya.